When you look up at the night sky in San Antonio, you see the moon and the stars and maybe an occasional meteor streaking by. But in the polar regions of the Earth, you often see something else. Sometimes the sky is filled with shimmering panels of colorful light, known as the Northern Lights, or aurora. Just 50 years ago, we didn't know much about the phenomena. But in the 1980s and 90s, scientists at Southwest Research Institute in San Antonio used a series of experiments to learn more. The CPAC equipment in front of you flew onboard the space shuttle twice to conduct space experiments with particle accelerators. Scientists used CPAC's electron gun to create the very first artificial aurora in space to better understand how natural aurora happen.
Results from the APPI camera, you can see a little glow to the left of center about every 15 seconds. We're going to cut back and forth. Here's another beam firing.
And then you see the glow that you see in the middle is the natural aurora, and in the middle of that you can see the spot from the beam, and that is really the first time that this has been done in space and that we have been able to watch it from with a camera.
So that beam really did look like one of the phasers that is in Star Wars or Star Trek. It's really an amazing phenomenon to see this come out of the orbiter for the first time.
Natural aurora are produced by the solar wind, a constant stream of charged gas that brushes past the Earth. The Earth is like a gigantic magnet, which traps some of the charged particles. As the particles are captured by Earth's magnetic field, they collide with atoms and molecules in the upper atmosphere, causing the particles to glow, producing colored lights in shades of red, green, and blue. Knowing about Earth's aurora has spawned a great deal of science to understand related phenomena. Juno, another mission led by Southwest Research Institute scientists, is on its way to Jupiter to study, among other things, the powerful aurora created by its massive magnetic field.